Right, so we've had a look at conditionals, and we're going to have a little look at something called logical operators, and specifically and, or, and not. Okay, and again, these give a little bit more flexibility to our conditional statements. Okay, so we've got a conditional statement that says, do you like cheese? And we could, for example, now add another input statement, which we'll call choice two, input. And what do you like with your cheese? Okay, so we've got now another input statement that we can do something with. So let's say if choice one is yes, or if choice is yes, actually let's make this a bit easier because now we've got two choices. I'm going to change original choice to choice one. So choice one, choice two. So if choice one is yes, so if they say they like cheese, well done, you're a cheese legend. Now everyone knows biscuits go well with cheese. Okay, so let's use a logical operator. So if choice one is yes and choice two is equal to, let's say, crackers. Okay, cheese and crackers, classic combo. We'll say, well done, you're a cheese legend. Okay, then we could have elif choice one, okay, is yes, and choice two is equal to bread. Okay, bread and cheese. We can change that to not a great combo. Okay, and we'll just change choice from there to yes, and we won't add an extra logical operator. Okay, so the way this is structured is we have our first input statement, choice one. Then we use AND, which in this case is the logical operator, and then we have our second input statement. Okay, now a sort of common mistake a lot of people make is they sometimes forget this bit. So they might write, if choice one is yes and crackers, that kind of wouldn't do anything, wouldn't make sense. We have to declare the second, in this case, input statement. Okay, so let's try a couple of things here. Oh, what have I done? I have forgotten the speech mark. Okay, let's pop that in there. Okay, so do we like cheese? So let's try and get this first option going. So yes, what do you like with your cheese? Crackers. Okay, so because we've typed in both, we should have, well done, you are a cheese legend. Okay, good. So let's run this again. And just see what happens. Do you like cheese? Yes. What do you like with your cheese? Slugs. Okay. So we've got this happening because the logical operator for choice two didn't tally up with what we'd written. In other words, slugs. So it just said that. Okay. So this is how we could use the AND logical operator. Now, here's something else. So we could change this to OR. Okay, and let's see what effect this has. So if we run this now, and we'll just do this with the first option. So do you like cheese? Let's say no. What do you like with your cheese? Crackers. Okay, so what do you reckon we might see when we press enter now? Okay, so have a little think and let's just see. So I'm just going to press enter. Well done, you are a cheese legend. Okay, now the reason this has happened is because we use the OR operator. Okay, so choice one was no, or choice two was crackers. So as long as one of these is kind of correct, okay, or matches what we've put here, it will give us this statement here. All right, so have a little go with logical operators, maybe with your music program if you've written that one, and try AND and OR, and maybe try NOT as well and see what effect that has in the logical operator. You could even have more input statements and string more logical operators together. Okay, you could have three or four. So give that a go and see how you go.